Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at valderbeebeshow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/valderbeebeshow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Good morning and welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show. Hopefully you enjoyed the music while I was gone. Now I'm back. I'm back with Dr. Kaufman and Dr. Melissa Kaufman and Dr. Linda Bryce. They're here to talk about incontinence and COVID-19. This is a challenge for 55 million U.S. adults. Let's hear what they've got to say. Dr. Kaufman, welcome. Dr. Bryce, welcome.
Good morning. Yeah. Thank you for having us.
Greetings from Nashville to Dallas.
Oh, of course, one of my favorite cities. I want to go on vacation there again. Haven't been there in a long time. But you're not here to talk about Nashville. You're here to talk about incontinence and COVID-19. Yeah. Tell me, what did we miss?
Yeah, thank you so much for that introduction and that question, Valder. You know, what we're really discussing here today is a condition called overactive bladder. And overactive bladder is basically a group of symptoms that a person may experience that's characterized by urinary urgency. So this is a sudden and compelling desire to have to urinate, which is often associated with a frequent need to urinate, which can be both daytime and nighttime, and sometimes associated with leakage of urine.
Okay. And it says, my notes say 55 million U.S. adults are impacted by this. Is that correct?
It is more common than things like high blood pressure, diabetes, Alzheimer's disease. This is a very prevalent condition, you know, and there's a wide variety of issues that can result in these types of bladder symptoms. But let me add right now is that very seldom is it associated with something that is imminently worrisome. There are associations, though, with things like aging, with hormone loss, with prior surgeries, but even something as subtle as back strain can result in these types of overactive bladder symptoms. So it's not expected or normal, but it is very common.
Dr. Kaufman, before I go to Dr. Linda, my audience is made of baby boomers. 89.9% of them are female baby boomers. So that says a whole lot of them are probably impacted by this. Is there a reason for this? Is it just aging? Tell me about that.
Yeah, that's an excellent insight. And that many patients do have impact as they age. There can be differences in blood supply to the bladder. There's certainly differences in the nerve inputs throughout the entirety of the body. And that impacts the bladder and pelvic floor. Plus, we accumulate insults as we go along. And of course, you know, I'm not certain that things really do get a lot better after you hit age 50. And it seems to be that that's the time frame when some of these issues begin to manifest the most. But we see them from pediatric patients to octogenarians. So it can span the entire spectrum.
Okay. Let me come back to you, Dr. Linda. You
yes.
can tell us about this firsthand because you're a doctor, but you're also a patient.
Right, right. I get to experience it from both sides. That's true. Mine started when about 17 years ago, and during that time, I didn't go to my doctor. I didn't want to talk to anybody about it. I tried to deal with it. And it's not something that you need to keep quiet. You need to be able to talk with your doctor about it, especially with the COVID-19 right now and bathrooms closed. You've got people in panic because they can't find a bathroom. And it's important that these people talk with their doctor to begin with and then see a specialist like Dr. Kaufman. She's my hero. She's the one that has given me back my freedom and my life to be able to have a good quality life. There's a lot of different treatments. The one that I chose was the surgical one. is the Medtronic InterStim device, and it has changed my world. It has given me that freedom that I didn't have before.
Let me ask you just a personal question. Well,
sure.
You can't get any more personal than this. because you're a doctor and a patient, do you have more empathy for patients, not necessarily just this disease, but when we come to these offices and want to be seen by our doctors? And nothing, no dispersion on you, Dr. Melissa, but a lot of times we feel like doctors are going next.
Right.
They're not hearing us.
I think it's important, you know, there's no way that a physician or a nurse practitioner that can experience all diseases, but I think that the more that you have a disease yourself, you are definitely more empathetic to your patient. You understand, and the fact that most patients are coming and that they're afraid to talk to you, they're afraid to ask questions. I think it's important for your medical physician or nurse practitioner to be open with them, to make them feel comfortable and that they can speak about anything without being looked down at or made, you know, to look bad. So if you're one of the individuals out there that are having the symptoms, mine was gushing urine when I never knew it was going to happen. It's important to go speak with your doctor. It's important to get your life back.
Yeah, I would agree, Valder. That's very insightful, and it's an unfortunate part of some of the system that we are all part of today, you know, both as patients and as providers. But even after that, there are resources, that something that your listeners can do today to access information and learn more about their condition, because there are accurate and reliable sources of information online, and one that has a tremendous amount of knowledge base and can help steer people in the correct direction is at controlleaks.com/now. And at that website, they'll be able to learn more about their bladder conditions and determine if this is really what's happening to them and how do I find that compassionate provider who's going to listen and is going to give me care. But I do find that there are many patients who are reluctant to come and seek treatment for those reasons and because it is a very delicate, intimate, and embarrassing condition.
Dr. Melissa Coffin and Dr. Linda Bright, thank you so much for being here. And I want to remember my audience to remember November is Bladder Health Awareness Month. So if you've got a problem, you've got some tools now. Go online and you've talked to two of the best doctors who can talk about this topic. Ladies, thank you so very much. And thank you for what you do. And thank you for sharing.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is My Phone Pouch. My Phone Pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.